Hello and welcome to the episode 52 of What a Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Today's highlights include the first time the Beatles played three concerts in a day, the completion of Fixing a Hole, and some work on Paul McCartney's first solo album. The 21st of February 1961 was the first time that the Beatles performed three times in a single day. The lads, still with Pete Best on drums, performed a lunchtime concert at the Cavern Club, joined by their former bass player and friend, Stu Sutcliffe. You might recall me saying that Stu had come back from Hamburg, West Germany, in episode 20 of What a Fab Day. Today was the only time he rejoined his friends for a live performance. At night, the Beatles appeared at the Casanova Club for an event promoted by Sam Leach, and later, they were at the Litherland Town Hall. All the three venues were in the Liverpool area, but still, it was an important milestone for the band. It won't be the last time that accommodating all the requests would mean performing three different venues in a day. We come close to that record in 1962, with two performances at the Cavern Club in the same day. The Beatles, featuring Pete Best on drums, had a lunchtime and an evening concert in the venue that they're most associated with. In the evening, they shared the stage with Ken Dallas and the Silhouettes, and Steve Day and the Drifters. Another two concerts in 1963, but this time it's two houses at the same venue, the Majestic Ballroom in Birkenhead, with the lads appearing at 7:30 and 11:30 p.m. With their growing popularity and the management of Brian Epstein, the Beatles found themselves performing more concerts in the same venue, rather than rushing about to honor their engagements. And it's time for another quick reminder. If you're liking the series, please visit www.simonmas.com/support. You can be fab and make the difference, helping me creating the best music-related content for your enjoyment and to make me feel that you actually care. Thank you! On the 21st of February 1964, the Beatles flew from Miami, Florida to New York City, and then from New York to London. This concluded their first glorious visit of the United States. In 1967, we find the Beatles busying themselves again at the EMI Studios. Today, they worked on Fixing a Hole, adding overdubs on the track recorded at the Regent Sound Studio on the 9th of February and completing the piece. The 7 p.m. to 12:45 a.m. session had in fact started with an attempt at remaking the song, but on hearing the result, the Fabs decided that the Regent Sound Studio version was better and started working on that, recording another rhythm track with drums, bass and harpsichord, so that the final version of the song contains two parts of those three instruments. The session was rounded up with the completion of several mono mixes and an edit of mixes 3 and 6, which can be heard in the album version of the song at about 2 minutes 6 seconds into the piece. Finally, in 1970, it was time for another Beatle to complete his first solo album. For the first time, and booking the session himself with the Billy Martin pseudonym, Paul McCartney worked at the EMI Studios to complete several stereo mixes for his McCartney. Between noon and 8 p.m, with a break of an hour at 2:45 p.m, he completed his work on The Lovely Linda, Mama Miss America, Sing Along Junk and Glasses, along with some recordings for a new, incomplete song called Suicide. Paul had worked at the Morgan Studios in London in secret several times between the 10th and the 20th of February 1970, trying to complete the work made at home on several songs and recording Hot That Sun and Crean a Crore. His move to the EMI Studios is generally considered to signal the final phase of the production of his solo LP. And now it's time to say goodbye again. Another episode of What a Fab Day is over, but we will meet again tomorrow for more Beatles facts and stories. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.